And the next reading and the message is from Dr. and Mrs. Waswa.
The reading is taken from Matthew 11, verses 28 to 30. Come to me, all you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. That ends the reading.
Thanks.
We trust the Lord with all our hearts and not lean on our own understanding, but place all our concerns, everything, to the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, then the next one is from Dr. and Mrs. Chibuka.
Can you put this at 5? You know that?
I'm very pissed off at you right now. Because the battery died and there's nothing I could do.
Let's have Mrs. Professor coming forward.
She's not yet ready.
Okay, then let's call the next one. We can come back to that one later. It is Psalm 28. Okay, you have to get it. Okay, the next one is from Dr. and Mrs. Drabili.
Doctor is not here, but I see my person there. Come and be next to my heart. Maybe I'll keep count.
Don't change the
color. The reading is from 1 Thessalonians 5, 14 until 23. And I'll read from the NIV. And we urge you, brothers and sisters, warn those who are idle and disruptive. Encourage the disheartened, help the weak, be patient with everyone. Make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, but always strive to do what is good for each other and for everyone else. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the spirit. Do not treat prophecies with contempt, but test them all. Hold on to what is good. Reject every kind of evil. May God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your Holy Spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Then sings my soul.
Thank you so much. I think let's also go to Dr. and Mrs. Baguma to come forward and give us a reading and a message. Are they here? Okay. Okay, we can skip that one and then let's have a hymn and then Huntington Cassidy will be next in. Come forward, and then Mr. and Mrs. Koikoyang Jr. will come in after that.
My burdens gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to me. How great thou art, how great thou art. Thank you.
Mr. Huntington Kasirye. Anyway, Isaiah chapter 9, by the way, you're very, very welcome. You all look very good, look very dapper. Thank you so much for coming through. And we are so humbled to have you here. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 9. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. I have a lot to say about my late beloved grandmother. If there is anything, the world doesn't have so many gentle people. We live a world of a life of trying to fight, we clamor for things, we fight for this, we fight for, you know, there are relationships that break down and we are unable to mend them. There is a lot of chaos. My grandmother was an epitome of calmness. She was a peacemaker. Every time and again I would fly to Uganda, I would go and see her. She would ask me to sit besides her. She would ask me in Uganda that one. Rarely do we have that lately in life. I celebrate her so much, and I thank God that we were able to talk to her a few months or even a few days before she passed. And what really actually hurts me so much, I remember the day she passed away, the weekend before, Mom calls me to the hospital and she's like, Huntington, do you have a friend going to Uganda? There's lots of medicine, there's walker, you know, there is a lot. There are shakes and all that, you know. So I had a friend who came around, so I told him, let's go to Mom's office. We went to Mom's office, we packed everything. And then this friend of mine left on a Sunday. I dropped him at the airport on a Sunday. Then I phoned him, he's arrived in Uganda. So on Monday at 6 in the morning, I phoned this friend of mine. I'm like, bro, please, better take this medicine from Pelere to Jeja. So he's like, you know what, Huntington, I'll do it. The next thing, 10 o'clock in the morning, so now this friend of mine is phoning me and he's like, Huntington, I'm on my way to Pelere. So I tell him that, you know what? That journey is in futility. Jaja has passed. So he thought it was the usual banter. It's like, Huntington, please get serious for once. And, you know, get serious. I'm like, Jaja has passed on. It was so, himself, he was so heartbroken, and he was like, I cannot believe that I was just maybe like 5 or 10 kilometers away. Guys, your 5 kilometers or 10 kilometers are not that long. You get what I'm saying? You know, so value your time and love one another as Jaja loved us. She would come here for treatment. We would take a walk around. She would ask me to sit here, you know, cut me a fruit. So all those memories are still with us, but physically, she's gone. May her soul rest in peace.
And for those of us who are still here, yeah, you know what? We still have a life. Let's celebrate.
Start with 2 Corinthians verses 5-1. Because when we are clothed, we will not be found naked. For while we are in this tent, we groan and are burdened, because we do not wish to be unclothed, but to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. The word of the Lord.
Some ways to follow. You may have passed on, but your memories will always live on within us. Thank you for your sacrifices, your care and concern, your love and everything that you have done for your family. Wherever you are, I know you are in a much better place. We will be forever grateful and thankful that you are our grandmother. My grandmother was a prayerful woman, always praying, and I remember whenever we traveled to and from Uganda, she would pray for those 4 hours going, she's praying for those 4 hours coming to SA, she's praying for those hours, and that's the power of prayer stood out to us through her, because we've always see it in the blessings in our lives. A lot of her qualities have been passed down, and we've been encouraged to have the same type of heart, a heart full of love, a heart that gives. Growing up, she was always giving and sharing with us whenever we went to visit Uganda, and she would always send her love whenever we were here in South Africa. Last year during the wedding, my grandmother's health was not at its best, but she had said, "I'm coming to the wedding," but unfortunately, her health didn't allow her to travel. But I'm grateful that she was able to meet my husband, and she immediately showed her love for him and his family. she'd always send gifts home with us whenever we went to visit, just so we could pass on the love. To my mommy, she's not gone. She's here, and she lives through you and through all of us. Just like her, you open your heart and your home for all to share in love, joy, and a warm meal. You did your best to look after her when her health started to deteriorate. The Lord has called her home to rest, and she's no longer in pain. May she rest in eternal peace.
Amen. Amen.
And after every verse, we are going to respond by saying, "Praise the Lord." Can we repeat that?
Praise the Lord.
After every verse they read, then we are going to respond in that way. Okay, I come forward.
Indeed, we never had the opportunity to meet our mother, our grandmother, but we are glad that the man who brought us here, Ofenze, got the opportunity to meet her when they were in Uganda. And every time we were showered with gifts, which we always enjoy, even up until today. And we thank God for that.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. In this regard, we praise God in his sanctuary.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him in his mighty heavens.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him for his act of power.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him for his surpassing greatness.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him with the clash of cymbals.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him with those resounding cymbals.
Praise the Lord.
Let everything that has spread praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
They always say, if your name was kindness, would say it's makasire. If you look at this humble person here, you would call her humble, or what is the proper English word? Humble, humbleness. If you had to define kindness just by looking at her, you know, you would say that's her name, kindness. Huntington spoke about calmness. I mean, if you had to define calmness, there it is. We saw, we felt, had kindness from Uganda. We've never met her, our grandmother, but we felt it, we are with it at home. I remember when Najita was showing me the album and showing me her pictures, I think it was either Fence or Najita, I said, yo, she looks exactly like my grandmother from my mother's side and also from my father's side. Because you just saw the calmness, the kindness before you even spoke to them. We are so grateful to her, because if it was not because of her, we would not be having an Ajita today.
Oh, yes. Yes.
So, the angel, and I know that she's somewhere there watching, we are very grateful. Because today you brought us a beautiful flower in the Kwikanyang family. For that, I don't know, words fail me. We are grateful to God for making sure that we have Koko Editha Naki Buka. She's also an angel today. Thank you very much.
All right, we now come to the gospel reading. Let's stand up for that. We will come the gospel acclamation will be a hymn, and then I will do that reading, and then just say a few words. that reading is from chapter 7 of Luke, and it's from verse 11, and it goes as follows. Soon afterward, he journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her and said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin, and at this the bearers halted. And he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." This report about him spread throughout the whole of Judea and in all the surrounding areas. Then the other one is coming from John, and it's chapter 14, verse 1 and 2. "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go, I prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be." The Gospel of the Lord.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, you can get seated. I think it will be difficult for me to say about our mother, but I think the one thing that we should be here for is to be happy, and to be happy for her life and what she has done. And as you have heard from so many people, this Jaja Mama was an epitome of simplicity, calmness, all we have heard. So there's no other way apart from praising the Lord for the life of such a wonderful mother, grandmother. And we should praise the Lord that she lived up to the right age of, when we was doing the calculation, it's 88 years. And not so many people can live up to that age. So, though we might be mourning, the family might be mourning, then, but I think all in all, this is to praise the Lord. And from what we are reading here, we can see that there's some acts that Jesus did about raising the dead. And from what we have read, that is what it was saying. So, with that, we hope that, of course, that she's also going to be raised, and she's in a dwelling place where everyone is going to go. The family is going to go as well, to join, because that's the route that we all follow. But the other readings that we did, for example, there is the one which was saying that, "Blessed are those who mourn, they will be comforted." Yes, even though we might be mourning, the family might be mourning, but they will be blessed. Everybody will be blessed with his mercies for the life of Mama Jaja. So I think even though there might be tears, but this is a celebration of a life worth well lived. As we have heard from everyone who has been standing here to talk about her. So I think that we should continue to emulate all what she has been standing for by spreading peace, by spreading love and simplicity, being down to earth. So I think I will end it there, and we will continue with a hymn, which is "To God Be Glory," and then we will have the universal prayer by Mrs. Sekatane. Thank you. Okay, we are just waiting for someone to come and do the universal prayer on behalf of the Mrs. They will be just here in a short time.
Thank you.
specialist.
Right, okay, the next one is to come is Tata, but we found it difficult to find him here, but there is one, now that we said that we met her when they were 20, I think the one we thought of first is going to be fine. So we will play it. Okay, we can still, you can play it as it's being called.
Thank you.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning. No kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My
ladies and gentlemen, my dad has requested that he wants to use Luganda for obvious reasons. There are certain expressions that he may not quickly find the English word. Nae Luganda lubere. Si Luganda. That's why I'm here. He requested that I interpret. Okay, that is saying we are here to remember his wife, Edith Nachibuka.
Twasinkana ne mukazi wange oyo mu mwaka gwa 5 mwena.
We met in 1954. They met in 1954. They were very young. Okay, so when they met, there was a lot of hide and seek. She was not so easy to be gotten. I told her one word. He said, I want you to be my friend, but I also want you to be my wife. She just looked. He said he was holding her hand, but she managed, and she ran away. So for him, he thought that it's over now. But that was the beginning of real love.
Okay.
But he said, I won't be with you until you go to see my parents.
Mwisele yo tuwari ntambule tegeleka na inaka gali na inga waluo jajangu. Eliamanyi kitawe wa mkazi wange.
At that point in time, there was no proper transport. My dad said he had a bicycle, but he had an uncle who knew the father to my mother.
Omusajja oyo yankwata ku mukono n'antwala eri kitaawe, kitaawe wa mukazi wange.
That gentleman led me to the father of my wife.
Bwe twatuuka eyo, taata wa mukazi wange yangamba nti alina muganda we gw'ayagala asale ku muwala we ebintu.
When we got to the father said that I have a brother of mine who is supposed to decide on what should be brought before you take her as your wife.
Twagenda eri kitaawe wa mukazi wange omuto.
We went to the young father of my wife.
N'agamba tujja kutwalayo omwenge.
And he said, you must bring the traditional, not vino or black label, the karabash, mwengomgan, the traditional beer.
By then, I had no money, but my father, the blood of my father.
By that time, he never had money, but the uncle, his uncle, made everything possible.
Netukutwala omwenge mu kifo bakiyita kibikke mukulembeze ebitabi.
We took two karabash of traditional beer in Bulemeze where she's hailing from.
Bwe twatuuka eyo twateekateeka ebintu bigwe mangu ne batusalira omutwalo ne batusalira ebintu ebyaliwo ne
okay, there were so many things that were requested. Among them, they requested for dowry, and they also wanted 600 shillings. Don't laugh. At that time, that was a lot of money. 1954.
Mwe wangamba bwe batyo nenzijayo shilingi lukumi mu bibiri.
But I was able to double the amount and I paid 1,200 shillings.
Mwe wangamba tati tiki wangamba bintu yu nebine mwagara.
After the 1,600, they say we do not have anything to say. Whatever we want will be taken from this amount.
So they pocketed.
At that point in time, I was given the lady as my wife, and they said whatever you want, whether you go and you do a white wedding or you do a traditional wedding, for us, we are done. And he was given a letter to testify what has transpired. From that point, we made arrangements, and we started to get to stay together as husband and wife. In the year 1957, towards the end, we got our first daughter, I was very excited at that point, and during those days, it was very difficult. If you're not the father or the mother of the baby, you can never see, not even touch the baby. She was born in the Namirembe Hospital. That hospital is still there, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes.
Kakati we are we grammar kabaka. Wari uko jamu ya mtu wala mtu aliyo yeye ni mmoja.
At that point when the labor pains started, my daddy's uncle had a vehicle and he was able to take her to Namirembe Hospital.
Mama wange yagenda yo amulabeko. Mama wange.
Yeah. His mom went to see Mama Saifa in Namirembe Hospital.
Nebamugana.
And they refused that you can't see her.
They were nagenda yo nebagala kungana nanga nchinza kugwana.
When I went there, they tried to say, no, you can't go in to see the child. But I insisted, I cannot go out of here minus seeing my child. The hospital manager tried to say, I'm so big headed, I don't listen, but I insisted I cannot go back before I see my child. Eventually they accepted and they gave me my daughter, I held my daughter. But I was so much worried. Since my childhood, I loved children so much. And people say, because of that, you may not have children. Even at this point in time, I love children. If I find people gathered, I always look out for the children, and I enjoyed being with the children. By then, I was working with the government, and I was so privileged because we used to have
Paternity
leave, so I would go and take my child to the hospital for medication. When my child always got sick, and I knew that my wife, she's a very calm lady, I thought that she may not be able to explain exactly what is happening to the child. So I took it upon myself that I take the child to hospital so that I exactly get to know what is happening. Every time I went to the ward, I was the only man in the hospital. And the ladies used to say that my wife bewitched me. Yet I loved her. So much. So bottom line, I love children so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, my wife never wanted any other woman to look at me.
It's a big problem. No, Rachel, we said, I am Munyabu, no, when Mokora, Nakora, and Kawanda, Sawa Kumi, Nemu Tus.
I used to work in Kawanda, but by 5, I was always at home. Every time I had names, there were so many questions for me to answer. So I used to explain, give lies, sell this and this.
And lies. And
lies.
Yes, yeah.
Lies part of life.
So, So at that point in time, I wasn't drinking alcohol. I had friends who are male and they used to ask me so many questions. What's wrong? How do you survive? You're always with your wife. You don't drink. How do you spend your life? Then immediately we also got a second child, a son, also from Namirembe Hospital. I was also refused to see the son.
We again yo.
But when his mom went there, she insisted that I cannot leave without seeing my grandson.
No, my husband.
The third child just came. At that time, we were in a place where there was no transport, and at around 2 a.m. in the night, my wife started complaining about labor pains, and that is Uncle Ali. So we had a neighbor who had some knowledge about labor pains. So the neighbor assisted us in that.
I had
read a book, a medical book, which was titled "Where There Is No Doctor." So,
Mukataba,
what can you do?
Mukataba ko bagante mukseno mukala zade o kuataka na maguga ko no kashulika. Kademe kumira.
You hear? Explain that they have understood.
No, say that.
So in that book, they say that if the baby is coming out, you hold the legs and you raise the child so that the child does not do what?
Does not swallow
whatever they can swallow.
And you can
chino chenda yarekiza nyokuba nga ruwo muwala ari kushara yowafanga yamira nga buri kishira afwekera.
I was so worried because in the village there was a girl who had swallowed those things and all the time she was as if she has flu. So every now and then I would go and put my ear on my son to see whether
he's got asthma,
whether he has that flu-like kind of situation.
Many the dancing in the home, Zarisa. You don't want to, Mamma. Now I'm from India.
That is Uncle Ali. Those names were given to him.
No, Rachel, Havana would not. Avala. To what if you are here when you send off Nanga, Mazokumania, Machine Hanga, Saint to Alaba and Duadio.
One time Cypher got a boy on Harley. I went to Mulago and I was given an appointment for 5.
Taxi.
So I carried my daughter on my back and I went to the hospital with her. So after the medication, I carried my daughter. We took a bus. By that time, we were paying five shillings, and we went home.
Cents.
5 cents,
50 cents, and we went home.
So when I look at my children, I always pray to God that my wife continues to rest in peace because we went through a lot of suffering bringing up the children. My wife was very honest lady. In my house, I do not need any DNA. When I look at my children, I see myself, I see my wife, I see my mother, the grand, so there's no need of DNA. My wife was very fast. My prayer is that God should write the names of my wife among the names of those that are going to be risen up and taken to the new land to
live. That's the name. Na amwe omukisa kubanga Katonda alabirira mumitima gyaffe.
Above all, I want to say thank you so much to God that I'm still alive, and I pray that my wife continues to rest in peace and she should rest well.
Nekirala, Katonda yatuwa obwongo bukunganya buli kintu kyonna, buli kyokola kyonna oba kirungi oyinza okugamba nti Katonda takiraba, naye obwongo obwo yabulaba alaba ebintu. Olwekyo bw'oba oli mulamu weegendereza okukola ebintu ebibiina kubadde weegamba.
So that is saying that when you're still alive, try as much as possible to do only the good things, do not do bad things. My father is saying that to my children and the grandchildren and whoever is here, it's very important that you're honest to one another, to your partners, so that we do not have issues of DNA in our families. That is my speech.
How you get your food?
All right, let's continue here. Tata left us in stitches, and I would have imagined that those days, 1954, that a man is a man with so traditional and everything would be to the wife. But contrary to that, he was actually the one. He's showing us how it is supposed to be done. So that was very good of him and the advice he gave. But let's now move on. But the ones who are coming, maybe we'll just try to move a little bit faster due to time. And the next one actually are the children. And then after that, the grandchildren are coming. And then the message from Dr. Miriam Kato, a friend. I think let me leave it to Flo. When one is done, the other one follows. So it is the children, the grandchildren, and Dr. Miriam Kato, and then Mr. and Mrs. Mbugua. Okay.
Yeah,
she's around.
Yeah,
Nicholas.
Okay, Nicholas.
Okay, good. Yeah. good afternoon, everybody. I'm going to be brief, but I'm honored to be paying tribute to my sister. And for now, I just have to highlight that Seifa's mom was my sister.
Oh.
Yes. We share some biology, physiology, somewhere along the way, DNA.
You have started.
And we thank everybody for making time. And I'm the mom for now in this house, or I'm the oldest granny in this house. And I'd like to take that opportunity to thank everybody for being there for us and joining us in celebrating my sister's life. I'm going to be very brief. I'll just tell you one thing. I'm a very quiet person. And unfortunately, the profession that I've taken requires me to talk the whole day. So I've learned to talk, and I can talk until the cows come home. I'd like to comfort my daughter, Seifa, and I'd like to let her know that my parents, your grandparents, your brothers, your sisters, the long gone brothers, sisters, I was sitting there and I was picturing them and I was just looking at my father and I'm just seeing him and he's saying, yeah, Edisana wo tuse. You know, like welcoming her and saying, yes, please join us and we can look after our children as ancestors, as us Africans would say. So yes, rest assured that she'll be comfortable with it wherever she is. God on her side, looking after her, and she will rest in peace.
Okay. Just to say, actually, Miriam is my mom. Because when I want to breastfeed, that I just want to say, Mama Miriam, Jolie, 5 minutes. So she's been very loving, very comforting. Even my other mothers from Britain, they're not here. I'm covered. She's my mom, even before my mom passed. And she's one of the people who made the trip to go and see my mom.
Oh,
yeah. So that's, So I'm going to be sincere and thank you so much. It's not only now at this function, but you know. And I've been reminding you on the back.
I'd also like to say something else because we're supposed to be paying tribute to my sister. And I, for whatever reason, have been forced to enjoy the internet. And I was checking at to pay tribute, what is tribute, and I was reading about words like accolade, praise, respect, and remembrance, and gift. And when you actually look at my sister, she represents everything. She represents humility, she represents sweetness, everything you can imagine. So I'd like to just point that out, that it's good to celebrate her life. And as we move forward, let us try and, this is a word I learned recently, emulate my sister.
That's nice.
Okay.
Nicholas.
Okay. This was, yeah, she's
the
name.
Yes.
So she's saying, but I think I've already said everything that I was supposed to say. Maybe only one thing. Every time I met my mother, when I came to South Africa, she believed I'm not going to church. She was always asking me, I was going to church. That was very touching. She was a very prayerful person who wanted everybody to go to church because she knew what somebody was going to church.
Dr. Waswa and Mrs. Waswa, these people have been there. They loved my parents like their parents. So I would be going to them and saying, oh, I'm going to Uganda. Do you have anything? I said, I have no information. But then she reaches there and she finds something to give me. And then all I get is thank you. So thank you. I thank you so much. I can just imagine this, that I think now at the moment there are no fruits left in Woolworths because they've been buying them and bringing them here, and there's no warm clothes. So if you go and you don't find jerseys and everything, it's these two. I thank them a lot, and okay, that is gone. That likes so much. They talk, if you come to visit, I give them time. Daughter, father talk. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for getting from the
dad.
I know you like to talk, but thank you for letting me know. Even I met the twin sister. Actually, we've been hearing about Nakato. So when we went for my mother's funeral, my dad was excited despite that, he was just sending us along, go make food, let Nakato is here, what is the chance? So it's that relationship that they had. And I'm hoping to come and so that we don't meet at funerals, because this is another thing. We tend to meet at funerals. And it's time to be happy and jovial and celebrate. Now, I have so much to say about you. Yes, I've had everything. My mom, I've lived all my life knowing my mom. No day that we didn't have before. There are times, of course, my dad didn't have a job. We never even feel that he didn't have a job. In life is like that. At times, we just don't have a job. I still give my dad. Because we never even realized that that doesn't have a job. She never had that negative
You brought your mom. And you said, Mama, this action. And then she would say, that is how it is. You know, you expect some, like, yeah, you know, what, but always it's less brave. Always don't hang with the wrong things done. Always don't hang. Always now. Go to my mother's house. I'm just full of people. I wanted to be so kind of a mistress. There was always food. You find people sleeping anywhere in the house, no problem. You get a pineapple, everybody gets it. There was always food. I would always go, and there would always be a Thanksgiving. And you find this thing full of people. But everybody would tell me, oh, this is my mom. In summary, I'm not going to in you know, everything. It stands for peace, for kindness, for love,
change,
for understanding, for forgiveness. I'm searching my head. See, did I ever saw her? And everything, how do you go forward? Did you send that? And I found my mother was sick. I knew he was sick, you know, but to see her before. I said, no, this is not true. So I went to the hospital and I went back. I went back in August. It was still the same. Let's talk about the medicine for the doctors checking on her on the daily basis, all the tests, all the scans, everything was done. And I had no feeling. In November, I went home. It's funny, we were preparing to go for this amount of work. But in my heart, I just wanted to go. I'm one person who's never going home and stayed in a hotel or his house. I go to. And suddenly, just before we left, my brother got an accident and his ambulance. So now, my mother's sick. My brother found some amputated. And I'm traveling home. So we passed through the hospital, it was almost 4 o'clock. And I reached home around 1 to 1:30. They told me my, they had packed my bed and everybody was sleeping. When I entered the house, my brother was okay. And everybody wonders how she got out of bed. She knew someone she wants to come. I sat with my mom. I already sat with her. When I was sitting with my mom, I recalled her heart and my sight. And especially this time when she's lost her conversation power, I would just sit with her and, you know, also taking that comments. She was sick, suffering, but she would never see her heart. And actually that week was very important to me. At the time we left home, just to go and buy something. Come back around 7. She was already in bed. And that's one thing I would have done. When I have moved, I spoke to her to say bye-bye. It's why I don't mind, but hello. I went to her bedroom, but then I was not going to sleep. She was sitting in her room. She was smiling. And she did this to my face. So it sent me in my talk thinking that what was that? Not in a bad way, but and yes, I am still emotional. Very good, fond memories of my mother, just personally between me and her, let alone the other people who cared for and the other women, she brought up. When we used to stay at the house in 10 p.m., when it reached our 25th year anniversary, that would be heaven and say, what present are we going to give ourselves? He said, maybe another house. And we looked, we thought, we said, we put it on hold. One day my husband moves up. He said he's going to look for a house. So I told him, okay, you find the house and you find me. So I went to work. Then he finds me and he's at the gate and look at the houses around. I don't think they were better than the house was standing and the price was very high. I wouldn't do it. So we settled to buy the lot. But when planning the house, we sat down and say, yes, we don't have it this way because our parents come, we had only one bedroom, we were self-contained, we pulled Chico out of that bedroom. You know, then we said, okay, let's get a guest house, let everybody room be self-contained, and you know, we were planning. But in my mind, I was looking at the situation. My husband was getting weak. He didn't want to go to public places anymore. He didn't want to go to partisan plan and say, let's get a place where we can have everything. So I said, we have to have a place where we pray. And actually, the first idea was completely different and even abandoned. But eventually we managed to get this church. But I remember my mommy had called me and said, I think Ignacio is going to build a church. And you know, there are those demands your parents put on you and you say, what's wrong with this one? I don't have money. And now you think I can. Of course, you don't tell. I just kept quiet. But that's what goes in your mind. And I know all of you. Parents ask some things from us. And if you are able to say, you tell them, I think you're crazy. But you just keep quiet.
Yeah. After experiencing life to its fullest, King Solomon, in Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 7, said, you know, King Solomon had a great time, the best of time. He experienced everything on earth.
And at the end of it all said, according to him, he said, life is useless. It's like chasing the wind. So here, I wanted to put in what he said about food. He says, go ahead, eat your food and be happy. Drink your wine and be cheerful. It's all right with God. Okay, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the food before us, for the hands that have prepared it, and for your abundant provision. Bless this meal, nourish our bodies, and strengthen our spirits, for your honor and glory. Amen.
Amen.
The word of God says that where two or three are gathered, whatever we agree on earth, it shall be so in heaven. Whatever we bind on earth, it shall be so in heaven. So in closing, I'll just say a simple prayer. And when I say all God's people say amen, all God's people agree, you say amen.
Amen,
amen means we all agree. Let's humble ourselves in prayer. Father Lord, we give you honor, we give you praise. We thank you for this day. This is the day that you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you, Lord, for journey masses, for every single person and family represented here that has made it to this tribute to man. Father, Lord, we pray that even as we go back, be with us. Holy Spirit, we call upon you. Please be with us in our cars. Be the driver, Lord, so that we may all reach back home safely. And all God's people say,
Amen.
Father, Lord, we'd like to thank you for provision. We know that it takes a lot of hands and resources to make something like this. So we thank you, dear Lord, for your provision. We thank you for this family that always shows love, involves everybody, Father Lord, with their hospitality, and they go over and above what we even expect, Lord. And we pray that you continue to bless them, O Lord. May you increase their territory, O Lord. May there be no lack in this house. And all God's people say,
Amen.
Father Almighty, the fifth commandment says that honor your mother and father, that it may be well with you and your days on earth may be long. Would like, Father Lord, to thank Saifa, her brothers and her sisters, the dad, and all their children and grandchildren that have honored Mom today. We thank you, dear Lord, that they looked after her in sickness. They have continued to take each other, to look after each other, help each other, and honor you, dear Lord. So we pray based on your word that you will bless them. Just as you've given Mom and Dad a long life, that you bless them with a long life, Father Lord. That their days will be long and their days will be fruitful on this earth. We bless your holy name. And dear Lord, we also bring every family represented here who have made time to come out today and honor Mom and Dad. Dear Lord, we pray that you give all of us, our children and our children's children, up to the fourth and fifth generation, as your word says, that you give us a long life, a healthy life, that our mental abilities will be afresh, dear Lord, just as Dad has shown today by going back up to 1954, things that usually would not be remembered at 90 years, O Lord. We also tap in, Father Lord, into that blessing because we are here to honor them. And all God's people say,
Amen.
May we say the grace just in closing. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.
Yes.
Let's all stand up and just say one more.
From here, thank you so much for your patience. We are moving into the tent. We are going to have lunch now. And then from there, we are celebrating our grandfather, Hand 90. So it's going to be a massive celebration. So today is a double one. You know, we are mourning, memorial, but as the dancers do, we do it like they do. So we're going to celebrate. Permission from anyone.
Yeah.
Don't.
Jimbo.
Jesus, give me tea.